Alright everyone, today I'm going to be showing you how to make this right here, the blood theme that you've probably seen on my channel by now. It's basically a tutorial on how to make your own channel theme, and I'm going to be doing it with Camstudio. Since I haven't made a video in a while, I still haven't gotten the camera, but I'm getting around to it. So let's start the tutorial. Alright, let's get started with this little tutorial here. Open up GIMP, it'll take a little while to load, but that's okay. And now get one of my templates, one of my YouTube channel templates for my DeviantArt page. If you haven't seen it, go watch my other video on how to get these templates from my DeviantArt page. I've got it saved here, and I'm going to choose this one right here, the two-layer YouTube template. It's a black outer background and white where the text goes. First thing you're going to do is click Colors, and then Color to Alpha. Now select black like this, 060s like that, and click OK's, and the black will go completely transparent just like that. Now create a new layer, and yeah, that's fine. Make sure it's in on transparency. Click on that layer, move it below the other layer. Now right at this point, what you should do is save this just like this. Save as save it as a GIMP XCF image like this. Rename it if I would definitely recommend renaming it into something else, because what you're going to create here is you're going to create a much more usable and easier to customize template. All right, next step is I'm going to create a box between the video player and the video description below it. Why I'm going to do this, I'll show you why later, but I'm just going to show you how to create a new box right here. Zoom in between the video player, which is up here now, and the description box here, and click your rectangle select tool like so. And then create a box, like maybe, I'll start with 4 pixels between each side. I'm going to go all the way to the end, wherever the heck that is. There it is. And 4 pixels would be right here. Yeah, that's good. And I think I'm going to shrink it 1 pixel on each side, just to make it look a little sleeker later. You'll see what I mean. And I'm going to take the bucket fill tool, and I'll fill it in with white. I flipped the background and foreground layers. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. If you make a mistake, you can always go back in the history just like that. Make sure you got the box layer selected with all the white boxes, and then fill in on that layer only. You want to keep the layer that's below everything else, the new layer right here, unselected and untouched. And so you have one layer for the boxes and one layer for the background. That's the idea. Now click select and then none. Now you won't be selecting that box anymore, and you've got a perfectly clean box right here. Alright, the next thing I'm going to do is get rid of this video player box right here. Why I'm going to get rid of this video player box, I'll show you. I shouldn't say I'll show you why. It's because the video player box is kind of quirky on the beta channels. It kind of moves slightly, so I'm just going to get rid of the video player box altogether. So I zoomed out there with this zoom tool right here, and now I'm going to take the rectangle select tool, and I'm going to draw a box right around the video player, and click edit, cut. Bye-bye, video player, I hardly knew ye. Alright, now I'm going to be adding just a little bit of detail to those boxes. Namely, I'm going to round the corners of all those boxes. So click the rectangle select tool, and then zoom in to one of these. Whoops, that's zoom out. Oopsie daisy. Zoom in to, wow, shoot, one of those boxes. 200 is fine, I think. And, okay, now rectangle select tool again, because I screwed up there. And draw a box. I mean, the same size of the box. Draw a box the same size of the box. I keep saying draw the box. Okay, now click rounded corners and make the radius, 8 is fine. And then click select, invert, and take your eraser tool and circle brush. That circle 11 brush is probably going to be fine. And erase the corners. What that select inversion did was instead of only being able to erase inside the box, now you're able to only erase outside the box. Now what you gotta do is be very careful not to erase this right here. Oh, poopers, I just did. So if you do accidentally, just click on the undo history here and then just go back a few steps until that disappears completely. You know, until you get to a place that you don't have any problems. Okay, now select none. Now I'm going to highlight another box right here. And I'm going for these boxes right here because the channel template's going to go way below the screen on any YouTube panel, like way down here. We don't need to round the corners on the way, way bottom of the channel template. So I'm just going to be rounding the... Oops, select invert. Forgot about that. I'm just going to be rounding the tops of these two boxes right here. This one here, and then this one over here. I'm going to show you which boxes. Zoom out. Only round, select none. Only round off the top portions of the boxes on this one and on this one. All the other ones round off completely. Alright, now with all your boxes rounded, click select and none. Now we can zoom out and see the whole picture here. Just like this, you can see the boxes are a little bit rounded on all of them, which gives it a nice, sleek, clean look. Alright, now what we're going to be doing is go to the layers here, click on the layer that has the boxes, and then right click on it and click alpha to selection. That'll create a dotted line all over the boxes. I mean, I should say all around these boxes. Now click edit. Select grow by, yeah, one pixel is good. And now I'm going to click edit. Hold on a sec. I want black. Edit, stroke selection. Now whatever color you choose, it's going to make a line wherever those dotted lines are. I'm going to choose 2 pixels and then click stroke. This will create a black border around each of the boxes. Click select, none. Can you see the black border? You probably can see the black border. I'll just show you a little bit. Yeah, it creates a nice, beautiful black border around all the boxes. Yay! Now it's time to start doing the background. Alright, for the background in this theme that I am planning on doing here, I'm going to select that layer, the one that is behind the box layer, which is this one right here. I'm going to select the one behind it, and I'm going to fill it in with white. That'll make everything but those boxes on top fill in. Because it's below the other layer, it will not interfere with the boxes that are on top. Okay, now, just to be safe if you want to, you can uncheck this little eye here, like that, and that'll make all those boxes disappear completely. But you don't have to do that if you don't want to. But the focus that we're going to be doing right now here is on the new layer. Alright, now, it's time for things to get a little bit bloody. Literally. I'm making a bloody theme, yes. A sick, twisted, bloody theme. So, select this brush here. You can go get these brushes, all these blood brushes right here, from this website over here, freebrushes.com. Freebrushes.com, like that. And oh shoot, didn't mean to do that. I kind of knocked off my page, but whatever. Click on the GIMP here, a little GIMP icon there, and there are the blood brushes for GIMP. Download them from either Rapid Upload or, it's Rapid Share or Mega Upload. I just got to get the names kind of mixed up, and I'm going to go back to my channel here and minimize that for later. Alright, now take that brush, make sure you have the other layer selected and not the layer that has the boxes on it. And just let's make some blood splatters all over the channel like that. Ugh! That's messy. Try not to go over to the right side. Like, try not to overlap it so that the blood goes off to the left side. Just don't do that. It'll make it look, it'll look weird when you put it on your channel theme. Trust me on that. Okay, I'm gonna paste another one. Grab another brush, another texture, so to speak. And see, it goes behind all the windows and stuff like that. That is the reason why you have layers, so you can put stuff behind other layers. Another brush. Just keep putting blood all over the place. Blood. 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 This is what you get, man. This is what you get for stealing my Oreo cookies. You shouldn't have stolen my Oreos. I warned you, but no, you didn't listen to me. You didn't listen. So this is what happens. This is what happens, man. Yeah. And don't, by the way, don't overdo the blood or anything like that. Otherwise, it won't look right. It'll just look like a big red splatter all over the place, and it just won't look right in general. So continue to splash your own blood wherever you please until you filled in the desired amount of spots that you wish to do.